Hello everybody, and welcome to episode 1 of Korch Plays Modded Minecraft. Thank you for joining me in this amazing adventure, and I'm sure we will be having a lot of fun. So this will be the first official episode that I will be starting in this brand new single player world on a semi-custom modpack, mainly based on the Resident Rive Stream modpack, but for more specific details, either watch the episode 0 video before this, or you can check out all the details on my website. So today I will be starting off with the very basics of modded Minecraft. So pretty much as most of you would know, of course, what you would do is start, hitting trees, punching wood, and doing all that kind of fun stuff. But what I can see in the distance from my spawn is like somewhere over there, so it's like really close there, so don't worry about that, is that I found myself sort of a snow village, it almost seems to be. I have no idea like what mod adds that or something, but that would be definitely something cool that I will be checking out in a minute. But first, I think it would be nice to get the basic materials going, and getting achievements, getting wood, always nice. Woohoo! So, you know, that's always something I like to gather before I get started, is just, you know, some very basic tools. And, yeah, just see what I can find in the environment, see if I can already think of some quick options of places where I might be able to set up shelter for the first night. But, of course, like I said, because we have that little village over there, that might be a place to head for the first night. And if not, I can see a lot of spruce trees on my right there. Right there. So that might be a good place to set up shop otherwise. But like I said, I will have to see about that anyway. So, for those that missed the previous episode, pretty much what I explained is pretty much what this series will be about, and just talking a little bit about, that I want to focus the series a lot on, pretty much you guys. So, I really want to focus on getting more viewer interaction, and also doing a lot of fun stuff with you guys. And of course, due to this being a single player, it has its limitations, and I'm getting so many achievements at the same time. But of course, I would like to get a lot of you guys' feedback. Because, of course, single player can be fun, and of course, especially if you start recording it, because otherwise I wouldn't be a YouTuber if I didn't enjoy recording my episodes, and, well, technically also a bit talking to myself. Yeah, bad stuff. But that's in some way also kind of a fun thing to do, believe it or not. So, I really hope to get lots of you guys' suggestions, either between the episode and such, and, general feedback of what I do. If you have any other ideas of what I could be doing, then, you know, feel free to let me know. But otherwise, you know, let's just have a bunch of fun together, and let's make it as much entertainable for both me and you guys. Because, yeah, that's the main reason, of course, why you would watch this video, because if it wasn't entertaining, then I'm sure you wouldn't be joining in that long. At least, I wouldn't be if I would watch a video that's kind of boring. Yeah. Of course, makes all much sense. So let's see, get myself a bit of cobblestone. Get some basic tools going. Make a couple more sticks, of course. And I start off with like a bunch of books that I don't need, but I will probably use them later. So let's see. First of all, a stone sword. A stone axe. A stone shovel. A stone hoe. What else do I need? A stone pickaxe. And a furnace. Here we go! Let me quickly turn my sound down a little bit, because it might be a little bit too loud for you guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I will use this furnace in a minute. So first I would like to quickly kill the scout, because food is always nice. And then I will head back to that village over there and see if there's anything interesting to be seen. Are there more cows here? If I can see in my minimap. Yes, there are. A lot of cows, actually. Nice. Always nice to have a bit of startup food to get going, of course. Because, yeah, otherwise you will quickly run out. Luckily, I do not have many big food overhaul mods. I do got like loads of mods that add tons of food. Like Pam's Harvestcraft, for example, adds a lot of food. Pam's Harvestcraft? Yeah. Like a bunch of different saplings and crops and tons of recipes that I can make, like eggs and sandwiches and hamburgers and tacos and I don't even know. Buy so much stuff. Even chocolate cake. Definitely awesome. So yeah, there's a lot of food stuff over there, but not anything too overhauling, like the actual hunger overhaul mod that only allows you, I think, to eat like 5 times the same different kinds of food. Otherwise, it will start giving you less saturation and all. I don't really like that mod because I'm more of a casual but still a lot of fun player, I would say. And oh wow, what? That's a lot of villagers. And this is one big village. Let's get looting! is there any easy way for me to get in here? There is. Always nice. What are they doing here? I don't know what they're doing. They even have ice fences by witchery? Is this a witchery village? I don't know. But this is a lot of stuff. Wow. Well, it's not like that I have, like, any emeralds anyway, so I don't think it would be, you know, don't want to waste my time a lot on actually trying to see that. So what is this thing? Some sort of ice castle, it seems? Are there any chests up here? No. Iron bars. No. Nothing here. No. Nope. Appears to be absolutely empty. I would assume that all other four rooms are empty too. And I can actually walk here too. Nope, nothing to be seen here. Any other cool houses? This is actually quite a nice place though. It's been a... Hey, did it drop emeralds? Not sure what mod adds that, but thank you very much. And crops and iron golems. This might be a pretty good location to actually set up a place to live just for the first couple of nights. Oh, wait. That's pretty annoying that these things, you know, there's no water nearby, so it won't grow very much. And of course we have potatoes. Awesome, awesome. Thank you very much. Helpful villagers, you are being oh so kind to me from time to time, even though you don't speak or anything. Well, technically it is sort of speaking like, but nothing too fascinating. And wait, did he just sell... Might be a good investment, maybe, to get this first emerald that I got to spend on a melon, so I can farm melons later. Yeah, why not? Might be fun. Always a good way of, farming and such, having melons. And now I also got carrots, and some more wheat, and more carrots. This is awesome! Yay, fluting villages! I do want to replant this in case I ever get back to this location, or... these villagers will starve out or whatever, I don't know. Yeah. That would be actually be quite a fun mod. That makes villagers being able to starve if they don't actually, like, have anything, any food to eat. That would be pretty much a bit too hardcore, actually. And bullying villagers. Anything here? Bookcases. I will probably loot them later. Anything on the other side? How much daytime do we have? Still plenty of time. No need to worry about it too much. What is this? I believe this is added by either Buildcraft or Buildcraft Editions. Nothing in here. Should I kill this iron golem? I mean, he can't get to me anyway. Yeah. Oops. I thought he couldn't get to me. I will quickly head back to this location. I will be right back. Alright guys, so the first death of this season has already been achieved. But I did manage to kill the golem after that, so I got myself 5 iron out of that. Which I am more than happy going to be spending most likely on a pickaxe soon. So that's going to be pretty cool. So let's see, what is this structure that I wanted to investigate? I believed it was from Buildcraft. So, oh wow, a bunch of kinesis pipes and a bunch of repeaters, and wow, even some redstone. Don't mind me looting this. Yay, free stuff. Always nice. I don't really need those kinesis pipes, and they aren't that expensive to make either, so I will just leave those there, because otherwise they will just be cluttering my inventory while I don't need them. Nothing in here. Anything interesting in here? Why are there, like, no chests anywhere? Aren't villagers supposed to be, like, you know, having chests in their houses and something. I want stuff to loot. Give me stuff to loot. Anything in here? Oh, wow. Is this a fancy place? What on earth is this? Crafting tables, empty furnaces, and some pistons. Anything up here? Bookcases? Oh, wow. This is a surprisingly nice-looking place. Oh, a bed. Nice. Okay, yeah, I died twice. Sorry. Didn't want to tell that. But at least now I have my spawn point set. And ooh, a chest. Holy crap. Armor. And a bunch of arrows. And a bow. And an axe. Nice. Let me get rid of stuff that I don't actually need. Like marble, some dirt. The rest I will keep on me. But I will definitely keep the rest of this stuff. Oh, and also don't need that pickaxe anyway. Yeah, should be good. Nice! This also gives me quite a nice view. I believe that part is from Realcraft. So let me see if that actually contains anything interesting. So, as you can see, this modpack already has a lot of fascinating stuff. Even if I just quickly scrolled through and not enough items. Like, we got a bunch of magic mods, technology mods, nature mods. Yeah, so much cool stuff to actually mess around with. Food mods, too. Yeah. So I can't actually wait to mess around with all that stuff in the very short future, probably. I'm normally known for, like, really rushing through the mods that I'm using, but like I said, I want to take it a little bit slower this season, as, you know, it might be a lot more fun to just, you know, don't just skip to the overpowered stuff and just do the more balanced stuff first, because, you know, that's gonna be a lot of fun too. So let's see, is there anything worth taking here? Slime pickaxe head, slime white guard, slime crossbar, nah, don't really think that's anything good. I do want to get a full guard, I think, because that's what allows you to get one of the things you can only get from these villages, because you can't actually make one of those yourself. There's some lava here, and another chest with redstone alloy, dark steel, gold, black lotus. Yeah, I don't really need that. Cool coke. You know what I can do? I probably will be able to use this cool coke to smelt up some of my raw beef. Ooh! A Tinker's Construct smeltery. Is this like an active smeltery or just the outlining of one? Because, yeah, it doesn't seem to be one that's actually able to be used. But that's actually quite a good location to actually loot a little bit later too. As it will help me get started with Tinker's Construct. One of the very, you know, I guess the most used starter mod at this present moment. Because pretty much it allows you to make very, ranging from basic to quite advanced, customized tools. As you can see from that little chest that I looted in that village, which was also from Tinker's Construct, you had like cross guards and sickles and different kinds of sword blades and pickaxe heads. And you're able to combine all those two things together to get some pretty awesome stuff. So let's see, this is, yeah, like I guess this is a Realcraft run, so not anything that I specifically need, I think. I'm not sure if I will be messing with Realcraft soon, or, well, most likely later, but not anytime soon. So, yep, pretty cool. So how is this stuff doing? It's still burning nicely. Anything else that I can cook? I can cook these potatoes. Nice, nice, nice. So then I think it will be probably a good idea to set up a home somewhere here nearby. Just, you know, might be good to make it like somewhere near this village, either within the walls or just outside the walls. But at least so I can be safe, you know, for the time being until I get like a dedicated home going. So yeah, should be quite a lot of fun. So while those potatoes are cooking, let's see. Is there anything? It doesn't appear to be anything on the other side of the wall. So maybe it would be a cool idea to just dig into this wall and make like a house, like semi into the wall. Yep, sounds like a very strange idea, but it's not something I've done before, and I think it might be fun. It will give me like a bunch of these useless snowballs, but oh well. So what I'll probably be doing is starting with a little 9x9 action, because of course that is the most known and safe, design for a basic house, I would say. But it's always very traditional and it works. But again, like I said, I want you guys to suggest what you would like me to see built this series, and maybe what specific mods you would like me to see use, because that would make this a lot more fun for the both of us. So I guess I could make it out of spruce wood. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's not 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, wait, it is 9. Then did I mess something up here? I did. Derp. Don't blame me. Okay, kind of blame me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What? Did I just make a 9 by 10? What? I don't even know. Let me quickly fix this. Alrighty, guys. So I quickly slept through the night and went on to gathering some wood for myself, just in the surroundings a little bit. So now I should be able to continue building this house just for the sake of the basics of making this house look a little bit pretty. So first of all, let me quickly get rid of all these things. And turn... Okay, I quickly put some in here because I was out of inventory space. I guess the first thing that might be best for me to do is make a couple of chests. Spruce chests. Can I turn these into normal ones? I can. Do I want to? For now I'll actually just keep them like this. Because it doesn't harm anyone. So let's put this away. Put all the stuff away that I don't actually need at the moment. Might want to keep some food on me though. And my bed. Okay, then I can put this stuff here too and get this stuff out. So then I want to most likely turn all of this. Let me get some access. Get a door. And I probably want to dig out the flooring of this house too. Just now I think of it. Because that would make this look a lot better to make it all fancy and spruce-like. Aesthetically pleasing. That's really also something I want to do this series. Not just brushing stuff, just plain brushing into stuff, but also make it, or at least try to make it look a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. I know that's not always my strongest side, but at least I can try, I guess. Because trying won't kill anyone, I guess. I hope. Because if it would, then it would be sad. So, yeah. Going to be pretty cool. Then I want some over here. How high do I want this to be? Probably 3 blocks high. And I ran out of a shovel. Let me make a stone shovel, and so I can use that iron that I got from that iron golem on something more valuable. Because that's maybe a little bit of a better idea. While I still have those resources to be able to spend. Because an iron pickaxe is always something worth making, in my opinion. Unless I want to rush into Tinker's Construct straight away. But for now, this will suffice. Quickly clear this out. Then I can put a door like right there. This right there. Looking fancy. Don't break that, that's my chest. Still have to get used to that. Not really used to playing with color chests, believe it or not. And up here. All looking nice and sharp. Alrighty, this is already starting to take a nice shape. So I'm not sure if I want to fill the blank spots that I currently left open with, also with plain wood. Or maybe get, like, if I'm able to get the claws or something, sooner or later, then I might be able to fill that in with that. But until that point, I might as well just fill it in with... I got an idea. Never done that before anyway, but it might look a little bit more in this theme of this place. But why don't I make some walls out of snow blocks? Yep, you heard it right. Make house out of snow blocks. Not sure how much snow I will need, but... probably quite a lot. Oh, and I need to make sure that I also make some torches, because otherwise it will get very dark in here. Where did I put my cool coke in that or in that furnace right there? I did already take the other stuff out, but not. Yeah, there we go. So can I use this to make torches actually? I cannot. What I probably can do is chop this one down, make some charcoal, and use that to actually make some coal that I can use for torches, because that would be a bit more helpful. It doesn't look half bad actually. Maybe if I turn this into glass while I when I have the resources and then leave the rest being snow blocks, that might be a interesting concept. So this goes right there. Let's make 8. I'm not sure how much this can smelt, probably a lot more, but yeah, doesn't matter. It's not like I need cool coke for anything at the moment. Anyway, so then I need to get myself more of this fancy fancy snow. Whee! How much do I have? Not enough. This is probably more fun than it actually seems, believe it or not. Okay, I guess this should be more than enough. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, do I have that? Yep. Need to make some more sticks. Combined with this, get me some torches. And they have a very fancy 3D model in my inventory. There, 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 there. Let's see, F7. Yep, no mobs can spawn inside my house. Nice. Just put some out here too, so no mobs will get a little bit too close. But for now, I think this will look a, you know, it will suffice as a nice base. Don't you guys think? I approve. You guys like it too? I hope you do. Pretty cool. So then what I want to do is maybe invest into an iron pickaxe. There we go. So I can go mining between the episodes and get some actual resources that will help me get going. Now I think of it, I might also want to get some of those Tinker's Construct workshop, whatever you call them. Like a crafting station. Oh, wait, did it have stuff in it? Oh, it did. Ooh, obsidian pickaxe head. Mining level obsidian. That's actually surprisingly useful, believe it or not. Because this one, I'm not quite sure what the level is, but I believe it's... I believe iron can mine redstone. I think that's how it works. If not, then I just, you know, made a derp of myself. So I will definitely keep that one. What else do you need to make a pickaxe? A binding and a tool rod. I mean, I got copper bindings, but I don't see any tool rods. Can I just use a stick? What do you know? This thing is extremely slow though, and it has a very low durability, but it can mine obsidian. So if I ever find something valuable, I mean, it won't hurt anyone just to have this laying around, I guess. So then I wanted to take, I got the crafting thingy, then I want a tool station, a part builder, and I already have a tool station. So for those who don't know it, this is how you would craft them otherwise. Just a piece of wood and a blank pattern to get a stencil table, crafted like that. And a part builder is a normal piece of log and a blank pattern. And then this one is a chest and a blank pattern. And there is one more that I didn't get, which I will craft in a minute. Which requires, I believe it's a crafting table and a blank pattern, if I recall correctly. Also, let me make a pressure plate. Also, as you can see, I got the Malaysia's door mod, pretty much making the animations of these things look a lot cooler, which I definitely like. Hope you guys like it too. Yeah, pretty cool. So, again, what did I say? I believe it was I need a blank pattern and a crafting table. Stencil table. Oh, wait. I did. There was a tool station in there. Oh, I thought it was only a stencil table. Twice. Oh. Oh well, then I at least have this one now. So tool station. It's the thing you need to actually put the tools together, like I showed you with the obsidian pickaxe. A part builder, which you use to combine your patterns and any material. And the stencil table, which you actually use to make the patterns have, you know, anything in them. Like so. Pretty awesome. So I believe one of the books that I got is also from Tinker's Construct. Yes, this one. The Materials and You book. And, ooh, Learning to Tinker. Nice. So pretty much, if you read this, you will see it will pretty much give you a quick run-through of what all the things do. And, oh, it even contains the actual recipes of whatever I just showed you to make. Pretty much, you know, having all the recipes and the things that they do, like the seared bricks is from the smeltery that I showed you, custom recipe for a book, quite useful. Tinker table, what is this? Night vision. Oh wow, that's pretty cool. Perfect dodge, stealth. Oh wow, that's some pretty fancy stuff. Never knew that stuff existed. Cool. Can't wait to get messing with that. So I'll be right back, guys. Alright, guys. So I just realized that I am already at 26 minutes into the episode. Wow, time really flies by if you're having a time of your life. So with that, I want to wrap up this episode right here. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed. Like always, if you have any feelings about this episode, either leave a thumbs up, thumbs down, or if your feelings are more complicated than that, feel free to give a comment in the comment section down below. Feel free to check out my social media. Like always, the links will be in the description down below. And of course, I would love to hear you guys' feedback on this series, because together we can make this series more fun. And no sticky keys for you. So, like I said, thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. Stay tuned for the next episodes. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, guys.